In the previous video, we were discussing about the message strategies such as cognitive, affective, and conative, and various types of the three message strategies. In this video, we are going to talk about various advertising appeals. So before we start off our discussion, I just want you to pause this video for a minute and I want you to think about an advertisement which you have seen previously. I just want you to think about the advertisement which has popped up in your mind first. Is it because of the product being advertised, or is it because of how the product is being communicated? According to you, which one is more important? We know that brands will have different objective in communicating to the consumers, and that is why they are coming out in the form of advertisement. But there is also one common goal for any advertisement you see in the television, which is to grab the attention of the consumer. So how are we going to grab the attention of the consumer? And that is where we are going to get the help of various appeals which we could use in advertisement. Advertising appeal normally refers to the approach used to attract the attention of consumer and to influence their feelings towards your brand or the product. So basically, advertising appeals are used to create and demonstrate positive image towards your product. So these are the advertising appeals such as emotional, rationality, sex, scarcity, humor, and fear. Let us have a brief discussion about all those appeals. So emotional appeal is something which evokes certain emotions such as safety, love, happiness, trust, fear, humor, reliability, pride, pleasure, romance, safety, passion, anger, and so on. So you can see this picture where you can see an emotional connection between the child and the mother. So emotional appeal, it always helps to establish a bond between the consumers and the product, just like the emotional relationship which you are able to see between this mother and the child. It also helps you to create brand loyalty by grabbing the attention and foster attachment through evoking such emotions. Fear appeal is one of the very important appeal which normally advertisers consider to use. Fear appeal normally it focuses on negative outcomes that can happen because of your action or inaction. I mean the consumer's action or inactions. We can consider the examples such as products ranging from insurance to hair conditioners, where the message will be conveyed in such a way that if you are not using a particular product such as insurance, probably you will be facing certain things in your life. So basically, fear appeal promotes an immediate behavior change such as eating healthier or quitting smoking or even driving safely. People will purchase a product to avoid being excluded by others. So that is the reason why if you see a lot of the advertisements of deodorants or toothpaste or mouthwash, you often get to see that the people will have the urge to use this product just to avoid themselves being excluded by others. But fear appeal has its own disadvantages. Sometimes it is considered risky also because fear appeal increases the interest and are remembered more. That is true. However, the severity and the probability of occurrence of the negative consequence is very important. This is because in the previous lectures, we were discussing about selective process theory, where we understood that the consumer have the option to decide which advertisement he should attend to, or which advertisement he should expose himself to or not. So if you are not able to find a right balance of using the fear appeal in your advertisement, then probably there is a chance the consumer might ignore your advertisement. So it is important for us to remember that low level of fear might not be noticed, and too strong fear may sometimes backfire because of the message which is being communicated, which can actually generate anxiety, and viewers may avoid watching the commercial. So that leads us to consider the humor appeal. Humor appeal causes individuals to stop what they are doing, watch, laugh at, and then remember the advertisement. It is a very effective approach where it creates emotional link between the consumers and the product. A well-executed humor appeal has a tendency to enhance recollection, evaluation, and the intent to purchase the products. But there are few disadvantages as well. At the same time, there are few advantages as well. So humor appeal always evokes consumers' interest. There is no denying that. Humor increases recall and comprehension of advertisements. It elevates the people's mood. So all these points are positive in nature, but there are certain risks involved too. You have to make sure the humor is not perceived to be very offensive. Make sure humor is not directed to one group, because that could prove to be very offensive. Sometimes overpowering humor appeal will make the ad will display the ad in such a way that it helps people recall the advertisement and describe it in detail, but cannot remember the brand being promoted. So that is a risk which is involved. In order to prevent that particular risk, in order to prevent the humor from overpowering the message, the humor in the advertisement should be closely related to, and it must focus only on the product and not on any one particular group of consumers. So the next appeal we are going to consider is rationality. This particular appeal focus on consumers' functional, utilitarian, and practical needs. It is usually informative in nature and emphasizes the characteristics and features of product. All those products which are rational in nature, which requires logical decision-making, will fall under this category. Usually, rational appeals are useful in complex products that requires a lot of cognitive processing, that is, more number of informations and so on. So, advertisers mostly rely on this message by focusing on product features and cost, and provide proof to back up their claims. Normally, this appeal is not suited for television advertisements due to the constraint in advertisement length, but it is best suited for print media, where you don't have any constraint on how much words you have to use and so on. If you have enough budget, yes, you can go for a detailed advertisement. And the main reason for us to say that this is best suited for print media is that because of the cognitive involvement in this kind of product, where more number of information is required, print media is the one where you have the option to put in a lot of details. So it is important to keep in mind that only limited information might be shared in limited time of the commercial. Yes, TV advertisement is not possible. Hence, print advertisements are the better fit for rational appeals. So the next appeal for us to consider is sex. It is a proper manipulation of appeal which can trigger subconscious human desires that result in purchase of products and services. It works when sex appeal is used in a way that is closely tied to a brand and a product. Advertisers have different approaches, such as sensuality, sexual suggestiveness, overt sexuality, or nudity. So these are the few types of sex appeal. The sensuality approach conveys sex in a loving and romantic way. So most of the advertisement which has a sensuality approach, you will always see a woman being portrayed there, because women responds more favorably to this approach. It is also viewed as one of the most sophisticated approach, and it relies on a person's imagination. Sexual suggestiveness is a stronger hint about a sexual theme. These kind of ads also suggest some sort of sexual fantasy. The third type is over sexuality. This is not very common in India, where it is not acceptable for sexually oriented products. We don't find such products in India. For at the same time, yes, it is available in the Western markets. It can be used to break through the ad clutter and to get people's attention very easily. The major danger of an over sexual approach is that it might offend people. So you have to be very careful in considering this approach. So these are the few points which has been put up for you to remember and consider. Even though use of sex appeal may have the product appear very interesting, and even though it may grab the attention of the consumers, there are also a number of disadvantages of using sex appeals. Using sex in advertisement today is not going to have major influence, because it is more common in televisions and in movies nowadays. Sexual themes may interfere with brand recall and affect advertisement comprehension negatively. Again, we have to refer back to selective process theory, where the consumer sometimes tends to interpret the message in a different way. That is called selective comprehension. So that's a risk factor involved. Studies also suggest that sexual appeal produce higher purchase intentions when the product is somehow sexually relevant. So the next appeal we are going to consider is scarcity. It's a human tendency to think that if an item is very rare or becoming rare, it is more valued. So that's what a normal human will always think about it. So scarcity appeals are based on limited supplies or limited time period for purchase of products. They are often tied with promotional tools such as coupons, price discounts, sweepstakes or contests. All of these, if you see, it will ask the consumer to make the action immediately. These ads urge consumers to buy a particular product because of the time or quantity limitation. When the products are made to be seem less available, that's how it is going to be portrayed, that it is less available, they become more valuable in the minds of the consumers. So scarcity appeals will be effective only if the source of the message is perceived to be credible and legitimate by the consumers. You cannot apply this appeal in every product or brand you wanted to, because you have to make sure that the source of message is credible. So that is very important. So these are the few examples where, if you can see the offers, coupons, which has been mentioned, it calls for an action immediately. So that leads us to the final slide. I just want you to pause this video for a minute and think about the product life cycle, as well as the various stages your advertisement will be going through. So I just want you to think about how your advertisement will perform at each of these stages in the product life cycle, such as introduction stage, how your advertisement will perform in the stage of growth, how your advertisement is will be performing, and same goes with maturity and decline. So that is all for this particular lecture. We have discussed about the various advertising appeal. In the next video, we'll be talking about the various executional framework required to design an advertisement.